Hello, my name is Bastian Kuhn and I'm a freelance software developer and Checkmk consultant. I'm going to show you today how to monitor websites, not only their availability, but also their certificates. You may have experienced in the past that a website wasn't available anymore or a certificate has expired. And I show you how Checkmk can help you in the future to act in advance. These two checks I'm going to talk about are active checks. That means they are not related to the normal Checkmk agent. So in case you have a firewall, you need to open different ports. Normally the website ports are the ports 80 and the ports 443. Or in some cases, you're going to hit ports like 8080 or 8443. Also, if you have a proxy server in your environment, you need to configure that proxy server later with your check. And finally, as you may already know, Checkmk has the principle of hosts and services. That means a service needs always be assigned to a host, and you're going to need a host in order to assign these new checks. The first thing we are going to do is to monitor a normal website. The dashboard is currently empty since I just installed the page and I added one single host, which I can use as an example. All the magic happens in the part setup. Here you can search for the HTTP TCP email, which you find beneath the services part. But I always going to use the search, which is a bit faster. The same happens now in the overview of the active rules. One of the rules is to check HTTP, but also here you can use the filter to get faster to your result. Currently empty is now the list of the check HTTP service rules, but we're going to create a new one here in main directory. Later on, of course, you can move it to every directory you want. This overview now is the default page for rules. It always starts with the rule properties. Since we don't need the rule properties here, I'm just gonna hide it and start right here with the check configuration. First part now is the check configuration, where we pick a service name. Since I want to monitor a web page, I'm going to choose the web page name also as service name. Checkmk will automatically add the prefix to the service name. It would be either HTTP if it's not encrypted, or it's going to be HTTPS if you're going to have an encrypted page. The next thing we need to do is to override the host name, because we're going to monitor a web page in the internet. So it's not the address of the host where we assign the service, choose host name. And now we can add the IP address, but I'm going to just add tribe29.com, which DNS can resolve to the correct IP address. Since it is a web server can host multiple domains. And to find the correct domain, we also need to add the virtual host. If we would not do that, we would monitor the web server, but not the web page. So we would just monitor the response we get from the default address or the default page behind the server. In this case, we need again to add tribe29.com. The last part in the configuration we need to do is to choose that it is an encrypted page. So we just check use SSL HTTPS for the connection. And as mentioned before, we need to assign this service to a host. This happens down here in the conditions part. In my case, I just choose explicit host and pick my prepared local host. Now I can save the rule and activate my changes. Now we're gonna take a look to the service. Therefore we go to monitor. Since I know the host name and I'm a big fan of the search function, I'm gonna search for localhost, enter, and I already see my localhost with just one service. It's my new check, HTTPS TRIPE 29, and resumes a correct response. But the next thing we need to do is to make sure that we actually monitor the correct page. For that, we can check for a string on the web page. In this example, I go to the TRIPE 29 page and look into the source code. It's like here. And in this source code, I see in this case a string we can use. It's like tribe29.com, the creators of Checkmk. I copy the string. Then I go back to my other tab where I have my Checkmk. I go back to setup. I go back to the HTTP TCP email rules. I search again for my check HTTP, which has one rule now. Then I edit my rule and I scroll a bit down now where we can find string to expect in response headers, string expect in the server response, fixed string expect in the content, and regular expression to expect in the content. Strings to expect in the server response, that's basically the first line of the server's responses, so also not helpful. But the next both are really helpful, since one is the fixed string inspecting content, and the second one, there you can even use a regular expression. In our case, we can go simple, go looking for a fixed string, enter what we copied before, and when I saved that, nothing would change since we can find the string, so I'm gonna alter this a bit in order to produce an error. I just enter a one in between. I save it again. I need to activate. Then I go back to my localhost. Since I don't want to wait for the next check interval, which is in 40 seconds, I trigger the reschedule here. And now we get an error since my string isn't found anymore. So in that way, we can make sure always monitor all the correct page. The next thing we're gonna do monitor the certificate age. For that, we go back to the setup again. Again to HTTP TCP email. Again to check HTTP. And I'm gonna clone my rule. It's happening with this button here. And as you have may seen before, this rule has a mode switch. Like you can check the URL or you can check the SSL certificate age. And I just switch the mode. And just a few options are left now. That are the thresholds for warning and critical. For example, I want to have an 30-day warning and 15-day critical. And one little thing I want to change is the service name in order to add certificate in front of it. That looks a bit better in the front end. I save it again. I activate it. Then I go to my local host and I theme a new check, HTTPS certificate tribe 29, and I can see that it will expire at March, and I got notification 30 days ahead before this happens. One little problem now in this case is the interval of the Checkmk checks. If I click into the details, you can see that the check interval for this service is 60 seconds. And normally I don't need to check every 60 seconds if a certificate still is valid. So therefore, I show you the rule how to change that interval. For that, we're gonna need the service description, which I copy here. Then we go back to setup and to service monitoring rules. But since we have a lot of these rules, I would recommend again, use the search and search for interval. So we have a short list where we find normal check interval for service checks, and that's what we need. We already have a default rule here from Checkmk. We create a second one. This is actually a really simple rule where we just enter like every hour we want to check that. And then the important part, we need to add a condition, otherwise we would change the interval for like every service we have. So I check the service part here. I paste it like that. And normally I would be finished, but we can do another trick here. If we don't want to create one rule for every certificate we check, we can go like this and remove the tribe 29 part. So if we name every HTTP certificate check like that, starting with certificate and then the domain, this rule will match. This is because here we also have a regular expression, and I'll show you what's happening when I save it. It says service name begins with HTTPS certificate. Just as a little background, if you don't want that, we can also end the matching with the dollar sign. It's not helpful in my case, but just that you can see, then the match is like exactly service name is HTTPS certificate. But again, it would not work for us here. So I remove the dollar, I save it, I activate my changes. I go back to my server, click into the details, and I'm now gonna see that the interval is 61 minutes instead of the 60 seconds from before. And the next thing I'm gonna show is how to monitor a web application or website running on the server we have in our monitoring, so not an external one. For this example, I have the mon server address here, which is the local host, and there I have a simple response, hello or hello in my world. I'm gonna copy that for later, and now I'll show you how to configure. It happens again in setup and like before in HTTP TCP email. Then again, it's gonna be a rule for the check HTTP, but much simpler than before. I create it in the main directory. I name it like my application. I don't need the host name. I don't need a virtual host since it's gonna be the assigned host. Just what I'm gonna do to prove that it works is to add the expected string in the content. I assign it again to my local host, I save it, I activate it, and we double check. And here we have HTTP my application with an OK response since the check finds this string here. These are the basic options of the Checkmk website monitoring, but there are a lot more. For example, you can even use placeholders like $hostname to combine that with a rule-based configuration check of Checkmk, where you don't need to have one rule for every website you want to monitor. But this is content for a more advanced video, which we show in future. So I hope this video was helpful for you, and see you next time.